In today's video, we're going to talk about the importance of having a snorkel and differential breathers and how they can help save you from a terrible disaster that I've had happen to me. And that's whether you live in a climate like I do here in the Pacific Northwest, where we get a lot of precipitation, or you live in the desert where it's really hot. There's two big reasons why having a snorkel can really help you in either of those. So the first one is, it didn't happen on a four-wheel drive. It actually happened on a Nissan Sentra SER Spec V that I had when I was in Florida, which is a lowered, basically tuner kind of a race car, right? So it had a cold air intake, and the cold air intake, for reference, was down on the driver's side here, and it was down close to the wheel well. It was inside the fender protector, but the reason it had it down there was to draw in cold air. But the issue with that, especially in Florida, is that when it's down this low, it has the potential to suck up water. And in Florida, as we all know, it rains quite a lot. And one night it had rained like torrential downpour. I'm talking about like monsoon. And there was a huge puddle, and it was just a puddle I drove through. And it wasn't turbocharged. It was just sucking in enough air to where it sucked up water through that intake all the way into the throttle body, into the combustion chamber. And what ended up happening was hydrolocking. Hydrolocking is when you get water inside the combustion chamber of your engine, inside the cylinders, the head cylinders. And basically, if you can't compress water, if you ever try to compress water, it doesn't work, right? So when you compress air and fuel, you get, and you use spark in a gasoline engine, or you don't in a diesel engine, that's how you get your combustion. That's how you power your car. Well, in this case, I had a bunch of water in my cylinder head, and it didn't end up working out great. So what happened is, if the ECU went into limp mode, when it goes into limp mode, you can only go above, like, you know, you can't go above like 1000 RPMs. It'll just bounce off a 1000 RPM rev limiter. Now, this isn't really relevant to four-wheel drive, because nobody's gonna have a lowered Sentra out on the track, right? But in the rare case that you do end up going through, let's say, a huge puddle that's on this side and you're off camber, right? And say that your stock intake was in this area here, somewhere up in here. Now it'll be behind these fender wells. You have the potential of soaking up water like that. The whole purpose of overlanding is so that you can see those remote destinations, those remote locations, and be self-sufficient. What this does, though, is it basically adds that purity of having your air come up from up high. Now, this particular one is the Ironman 4x4. I got it on sale, of course, like I do all my Ironman product. What you're gonna have to do to install one of these is you will have to be drilling into your fender. Some people don't like that. I didn't really care. This truck has 300,000 miles. This isn't a trophy truck. This is used for trails, and it is purpose driven. This is not a mall crawler by any means. This is going to have a bunch of studs, or a bunch of holes that you're gonna have to drill through your fender in order to put the studs through. And then, of course, one big hole, which I'll show you here in a sec, for the actual air inlet. And then up here, you can orientate this, the actual snorkel face itself, however you like. And you can see here, each company, Safari makes one, and I'll show you that one in a sec. Each company makes a different kind of grating on the outside, which you can actually take this off here if need be. But if you look, it's kind of angled down already. So it rains a lot here. I've never had an issue with water getting into the snorkel and into the actual cylinder heads. A lot of people worry about that. Some people actually, you can orientate this around if you'd like. So when you're driving like this, obviously you're not getting oncoming rain in there. That having been said, I've never had a problem, again, like I said, with it getting in here. And my intake system is a little bit different than most people's, because the FZJ 80 engine on my 80 series Land Cruiser uses a cyclone style filter. So this is going to basically connect to a rubber silicone hose here, and that goes into the fender well and connects to the snorkel. So generally it will fall out, or it'll go down in the bottom of here before it makes it into the engine itself. Other engines are different, but for the most part, I'm not really worried about water getting past this cyclone filter. Now, it depends on your application. Check and make sure. Some people, like I said, do orientate that actual snorkel face itself backwards. But then some people I've read have had issues with, you know, not getting enough air because it's not being kind of like rammed in, like a short ram intake. Anyways, another thing that you're gonna wanna do for waterproofing, Some people think you get the snorkel and you're all done. You can drive through huge puddles of water. That's not true. For intaking air, that's great, but you're also going to need some differential breathers. Now, from factory, most four-wheel drives will have differential breathers. And you can see mine here. I've disconnected it in case I ever need to retain it if my Iron Man one goes bad, but there's a little valve on your differential. Now I have a solid axle. If you have a different transfer case and transmission, then you'll just have to look for your application, but this will just lock on here to the little valve, really simple. And I have the same one in the back. You can see that one there in the back. Basically, they'll both just latch onto there. And then you want to run those lines like I have all the way up into your engine bay. And then just on the back of the firewall is where I mounted mine with some self-tapping screws here. And then they have these little, they allow air to go out, but don't allow moisture to get in. So this kit from Iron Man, I think was like $80. So remember, when you're trying to waterproof your truck, not only to get the snorkel, but to also get the diff breathers, because you're going to need both. You also still have a transfer case and transmission breathers. Those are tucked up underneath the transmission tunnel, and they have those same kind of valves, that little brass kind of valve at the top. So there's no way for me to really like get to those, or it's very difficult for me to get to those. So I haven't chosen to actually extend those as well. Maybe something I do in the future when I take the engine out, because I'm going to be swapping in a 6PT Cummins, but I'm not really worried about it. As long as I don't stay in the water for like minutes at a time, which I don't plan on doing, there's other issues with that. So the third issue, because most of us in America here have gasoline engines. If you have diesel, you don't have to worry about this at all because there's no spark plugs and it runs off of air, which you'll get from your snorkel, and fuel, which is all it needs to combust, the combustion. If you have a gas engine, like I do, and this is an older style that uses a distributor cap and rotor, you're gonna have to waterproof this as well if you really wanna be going through deep water crossings. Now, I haven't done this, but I'm gonna figure out some way with like silicone in order to waterproof all the leads on this and the actual cap itself. You can do your research there. I personally use I Hate Mud because, you know, that's an 80 series Land Cruiser specific site. Check your forums and see. I've also heard spraying silicone on your leads, be it on the actual cap lead place itself. You can spray some silicone spray on there, and that seems to help, maybe on the electrical connectors as well. Because obviously, if you lose your spark on a gasoline vehicle, it's not going to run, obviously. So that's another issue if water was to be getting, you know, up this high. So something to think about. Another reason that I like having the snorkel, and probably the most useful cause, I mean, I've never driven through water that high. I've driven through water a few times where it would have been beneficial and potentially saved me from a hydrolocking. But the most useful and most economical reason for having a snorkel is cold, clean air. And the reason for that is when you have your air coming from up here, it's not inside the engine bay. And my particular engine, it's an older style engine, you can't really see, but the block itself is iron. Just like these are cast iron. The block itself, like the long block, is iron. The head is aluminum. So the aluminum allows for good cooling. The block itself doesn't. And these do have an issue with what's called heat soaking. Heat soaking basically meaning there's a bunch of heat in the engine bay, and generally this would be your location where your intake draws air from. So it's reaching down there in the side, in the fender well. So that's far enough away from the engine. Nonetheless, I would have issues in the summer where my AC would kick off. That was before I installed this accessory fan too. But I would have issues where my AC would kick off. That was before I installed this snorkel. I just from monitoring my engine temperatures with a OBD2 engine monitor, I've noticed a like 10 degree difference in temperatures just from installing that snorkel. So that's a reason why, even if you live in the desert or somewhere where it's not that precipitous, it doesn't rain that much, it's a great idea to still have a snorkel because it gives you that cold, clean air. You know, if you're having anything smoking from this area too, potentially that could draw it in, especially if you have a turbocharged application, because it's really pulling in all that air. If you want to do a little bit more extreme off-roading and you might potentially have the chance of going through a waterlogged area, I would highly recommend getting a snorkel and differential breathers. That's pretty much it for today's video. Yeah, I can't really do much more on the big old 80 series here because we're waiting on a lot of parts in order to finish the 6-inch lift kit and then put 40-inch tires on. We're heading out to Eastern Oregon for a 3-day camping trip and to do something very special that we only do once a year. You'll have to tune in next week on Tuesday to catch that video, and it's going to be very special, and hopefully we will have a big trophy when we come back. That's all I'm going to say, and I'm sure you can probably guess what we're going to be doing. So until then, I will see you on the trails.